going on, everybody? Welcome back to another video. And Star Wars The Bad Batch is finally live on Disney Plus with its first episode, a 70-minute first episode, and I loved it. Had a lot of fun with it, and I'm going to be getting into spoilers. But for anybody who's watching this who doesn't want any spoilers or just kind of wants to know what my general thoughts were on the episode, I felt like it was a great introduction to the show. Very much excited for this to be almost a really true successor and sequel series to the Clone Wars. You have Dave Filoni at the helm once again. And I love that this is sandwiched in between the Clone Wars and Rebels in a way that feels like this is a more direct sequel series to the Clone Wars, but it almost feels like we have a trilogy as far as animated shows, with Rebels being the third portion of that. I like the way that this show connected to both of those as well as the movie. So outside of that, I will be jumping straight into spoilers. So that is your warning. Let's go ahead and get into this. This episode opens up with the Clone Wars logo, and then it ends up burning away and it goes to the Bad Batch logo. This episode was titled Aftermath, and it literally starts out with the narration done by Tom Kane, similar to what they do with the Clone Wars. So very excited. Really was looking forward to seeing what the show is going to be all about. The Bad Batch were introduced at the very end of the Clone Wars in the very first portion of that final season. And yeah, they're a defective group of clones that are essentially like the ultimate video game squad. You have Crosshair, who's like the ultimate marksman. You have Tech, who, like the name suggests, is the smart guy, the techie. You have Hunter, who's the leader, who's very much like a Rambo-esque character, the strategist. You have Wrecker, who is the Wrecker, the brute, the strong guy of the group, who's not all that bright upstairs. And then you have Echo, who is a longtime Star Wars favorite as far as the clones, who was believed dead. And then obviously we learned that he was not dead in the final season of the Clone Wars. And because of everything he went through, he ended up joining this group of misfits called the Bad Batch. And yeah, I really enjoyed them in the short period of time we saw them in the Clone Wars. And I wasn't expecting that we'd get a whole show on them, but I think it's amazing. And I have to applaud, and I'm very proud and very excited for Dee Bradley Baker, who is the voice actor for all of the clones, as well as very many other characters across the Clone Wars, as well as in Star Wars Rebels. He's reprised the voice in various things, including Lego movies, as well as video games for Star Wars. So overall, when you think of the clones nowadays and their voice, you very much think of Dee Bradley Baker's version, his voice behind all these clones. And with the Bad Batch, what made it cool was that, you know, he has this group of characters that he can play as that are all kind of different. They don't have to be exactly like all the other clones that all have pretty much the exact same voice because they're clones. Since these have a little bit more of a deformity to them, they all kind of have their own personalities. And so Dee Bradley Baker really gets to have a lot of fun with it while also keeping it within that same feel and vibe of what we expect from the clones. So I just got to praise him because the man's an incredible voice actor and he does such a great job. You know, when you're watching this episode alone, you're just watching the whole time and half of the dialogue is just him, you know what I mean? And it's so believable. He plays all these characters so well. He you know, gives you something to kind of differentiate all of them incredibly well, and I really, really enjoyed that. Yeah, so the episode opens up and we see the Bad Batch all together again. We are reintroduced to them as they are teaming up with Depa Pallava and her Padawan, Caleb Doom, who anybody who's watched Star Wars Rebels knows is Kanan Jarrus. So I'm incredibly excited to see that they connected right out of the gate to Star Wars Rebels, as well as to what was happening in the Clone Wars. We know right at the beginning of this episode that Obi-Wan is now on his way to deal with General Grievous on Utapau, and this ends up leading to, of course, another version of Order 66, where we now see from a different angle what ended up happening with the Bad Batch when Palpatine ended up calling for Order 66 and the execution of the Jedi. And so yeah, right out of the gate, it's a crazy first episode, a lot of stuff going on. We get to see Order 66 once again. And yeah, between the movies with Episode 3 and seeing Order 66 there where it was originally done, as well as some books and comics that have done it, video games like Jedi Fallen Order being the most recent one that has done it, the Clone Wars has shown us it, and Star Wars Rebels has touched on it. It's such an interesting time in the Star Wars continuity to be able to see from a various angle, you know what I mean? So really enjoyed that element and being able to see how the Bad Batch were involved with all of this. And very sad to see Depa Pallava die, even though we knew that that was going to happen, but super awesome to see a young Kanan Jarrus, or Caleb Doom as he is at this time. Yeah, so we ended up finding out, as I think we all kind of suspected, that majority of the Bad Batch was not at all in any way, shape, or form affected by Order 66 because of the fact that they have like those deformities. They're not your typical clones, so they don't have the chip in their head that makes them follow those orders. You know, that's kind of their whole thing, is they don't necessarily follow orders, but they'll get the job done. And the only one that we see in the group that actually is starting to struggle with that and wanting to kill the Jedi is Crosshairs, the marksman. And so that is an issue that rises throughout the course of the episode, and we'll get into that a little bit more. But yeah, it was really interesting to see them kind of figure things out. We're reintroduced to a lot of characters in the show, like Lama Sue from Kamino, as well as Grand Moff Tarkin, which is just really great to see. And yeah, this episode, we start to see the phasing out of the clone troopers, as now Palpatine has now called for everything to be under a galactic empire. And now to be able to see Grand Moff Tarkin start to phase out the clone troopers and start to move into the stormtrooper era, I really enjoyed seeing how that was all going down, how that worked. We spent a lot of time on Kamino, and we're introduced to a new character named Omega, who we learn later on in the episode is another deformed clone, the only female clone. She's a young girl, and she has like this admiration for the Bad Batch because she knows she's just like them. And so, yeah, they end up, you know, kind of taking a liking to this girl. She ends up working with them throughout the course of the episode. And by the end of the episode, she is with them on their journey. Not too long into the episode, once they actually are, you know, dealing with what's going on with Grand Moff Tarkin and the aftermath of what's going on, he ends up sending them on a mission to go take out some insurgents. And when they get there, they find that there's not any droids or anything that they were kind of expecting to see, but instead it's just refugees. A bunch of people, including children, that are just innocent but are kind of caught in the middle of this war between the Empire and, you know, what they're trying to do, you know what I mean, moving into this new phase of, you know, taking control of things, as we know the Empire does. And one of these people that we see, the leader of this group, is Saw Gerrera. So it's great to see Saw Gerrera now multiple times throughout the series. You know, we've seen him initially in the Clone Wars, then he would make his live action debut in Rogue One with Forrest Whitaker, who would also reprise the role in Star Wars Rebels, as well as Jedi Fallen Order. And now we get to see him a little bit closer how he looked in the Clone Wars, with a little bit of a, you know, middle ground between what we end up seeing in Star Wars Rebels and what we ended up seeing in the Clone Wars. So yeah, you know, familiar faces popping up here and their connective tissue to Star Wars, The Clone Wars, Star Wars Rebels, and the movies in the overall universe. And overall, I found this to be just a really great, fun episode. A lot of really great action, beautiful visuals, really great animation, very much in line with the final season of The Clone Wars as far as the artistic style. I think there's definitely a different look as far as the lighting and different things like that in this show, but overall, very similar to that look. And I'm really excited to see how they connect to different things. There's definitely a lot that was shown in some of the previews that are not, you know, yet happening, because there's plenty of episodes to still see. But overall, really enjoyed seeing the Bad Batch have to deal with Order 66, them figuring things out. Very curious to see how Omega plays into this whole narrative and how she's connected to the clones in this different way. I really, really enjoyed it. And yeah, I talked about Crosshair earlier, but we end up getting later on in the episode having Grand Moff Tarkin actually amplifying his chip in his mind, since he's the only one of the group that is kind of following the Order 66 guidelines, kind of falling in line with what the Emperor wants. And so Grand Moff Tarkin has his chip amplified, which ends up having him turn against his clone brethren. And yeah, so Omega and the other four have to run away and flee Kamino, leaving Crosshair behind. So it looks like Crosshair will be our main antagonist moving forward, with, you know, of course, you know, Palpatine and Moff Tarkin kind of glooming in the background. But it looks like it's going to be kind of an internal battle between the Bad Batch themselves, specifically with Crosshair being their villain. So yeah, overall, there's a lot that happened in this episode. This isn't a full spoiler breakdown, you know, but overall, I really thoroughly enjoyed it. I think if you're a longtime Star Wars fan that has kept up with the Clone Wars and with Rebels and the movies, there's definitely a lot in there to really have fun with, especially if you're a fan of the Clone Wars. This very much feels like a natural extension of the Clone Wars. And again, if you've seen Star Wars Rebels and the various other Star Wars properties, there's a lot there to connect to. So very excited to see what they do moving forward. I love the way they connect to the events of Revenge of the Sith, as well as what we kind of know happened during the Clone Wars. Thoroughly enjoyed this episode on a visual level. The performances were great, and for the first episode being 70 minutes, I'm incredibly excited moving forward. I think all the episodes after this are in the 25 to 30 minute range, so we'll see what ends up happening and how they end up, you know, containing those stories moving forward. But I found this to be a really great time. Great to see Dave Filoni doing animated Star Wars once again. Dee Bradley Baker was phenomenal as all of these clones, as he usually is, and it was great again to see that connective tissue to the Clone Wars, and to Star Wars Rebels in a way that makes this a nice sandwiched trilogy of animated Star Wars shows. So I really look forward to seeing how they wrap up this whole season, how it all kind of pays off throughout the course of these episodes. And yeah, that's going to be my thoughts on the first episode of The Bad Batch titled Aftermath. So please, if you guys enjoyed this episode, or if you didn't enjoy this episode, or you watched at all, please comment your thoughts down below. Hit that like button if you guys enjoyed the video. Subscribe for more videos. I'll see you guys next week for episode 2 of The Bad Batch. Bye-bye.